Well, that was good. Can we do that in slow motion? Hang on. Very satisfying. Oh, shit. Hi, I'm Michael Chakraverty, and I was on the Great British Bake. Ooh, that was shit. Hi, Michael. No, that's my name. Hi, everyone. It's Michael here from the Great British Bake Off. But today, I'm a guy making a pie. We're going to be trying out some pumpkin pies today, because I know that's the iconic Thanksgiving dessert. Although my mum does have a recipe, so we're following my mum's recipe. Hers is in blue. I've corrected it in black, even though I don't really know what I'm doing. So we're just going to crack on and hope for the best. Step one, we are going to make some sweet short crust pastry. You can do this by hand. I can't be arsed, so I'm going to use a food processor. So into the food processor, we're going to put 225 grams of plain flour. Like that. Onto that, we're going to add the butter, which I've left in the fridge. So 1 second.
Where is the butter? Oh, here.
I've got butter. So we have 115 grams of butter going in with the flour. So it should go really fine, like breadcrumbs. What you're doing is you are coating all of the butter with flour to stop it from kind of going gloopy together. That's science. So into here, we're going to then stir through 75 grams of icing sugar and a wee bit of salt. I feel like Nigella Lawson, this is fab. You can add some spices and vanilla in here if you want. I don't want to, so I'm not going to. Give that a quick whiz to bring it together. Sounds like a motorbike. And then we're gonna pop that to the side just slightly, and we're gonna get an egg yolk. Right, we pop the egg yolk in. We're gonna get some cold water, and we're gonna pop in maybe 2 tablespoons worth. We're gonna add a bit of water each time until it starts to form a bit of a ball, but you wanna use as little water as possible. Make sure your water is ice cold, otherwise you're just gonna melt the butter and that'll be embarrassing for you. So it's now started to clump together. So we're gonna tip that onto the counter and just bring it together a bit. Ooh, ow. Ow. So it looks a bit crumbly, but you just kind of squidge it together as much as you can. Pat it into a disc and get some cling film, or if you're saving the environment, beeswax paper, and just wrap it up so we can chuck it in the fridge to chill down. Apparently I hate the environment, so I'm gonna try and find some cling film in this kitchen. We're gonna pop that in the fridge and that can chill down for about half an hour to an hour. It can stay in the fridge for a day, 24 hours. And if you want to freeze it, it also freezes, which is grand, but it does need to rest so that the gluten relaxes so that it goes short or flaky or whatever that is. Okay, so now the pastry is chilling down in the fridge, we're gonna make the pumpkin pie filling. So we're gonna use 460 grams of pumpkin puree, which is helpfully just a bit more than a can. So you're gonna have to buy two. I don't know, make a soup or something. We're gonna pop in, what is this? Let's just say 1/2 teaspoon of nutmeg. Sure, it'll be fine. And then some cinnamon, 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon, a bit more than 1/2 teaspoon of ginger. I'm gonna put in 1 teaspoon of cardamom. And that's basically your pumpkin spice. Doesn't fit. Cool. Oh well. And we're gonna add 110 grams of sugar, don't forget. I'm gonna add zest and the juice of 1 lemon. And then I'm gonna cut it in half and pour that in as well. You can use a lemon juicer. I can't roll it with that either, so just use your hands. You can catch the seeds that way. No one wants a seedy pie. Seedy tart? That would have been funnier, wouldn't it? That's too late now. If you've got any cuts on your hands, this'll hurt, but like in a really good way. You know the good kind of hurt. You know what I'm talking about, gays. 2 1/2 tablespoons of milk. 1, 2, that's probably a half. Mum's recipe says 2 eggs beaten lightly. I can't bother beating things before I put them into a bowl to be beaten anyway, so I'm just gonna put them all in together. Why not? I'm lazy, so I'm just gonna mix it with this. But that is your pumpkin pie filling mixture. So next step is rolling out the pastry and lining the pastry tin. I roll my pastry out using icing sugar. I think if you add more flour, it can get a bit more tough. So we're putting some icing sugar down. just basically, you're providing a barrier between the pastry and the table. Well, that was good. Can we do that in slow motion? Hang on. Very satisfying. Oh, shit.
Hang on.
So your pastry should be fairly firm because you've chilled it down. You might need to hit it a bit to kind of smack it into submission. You'll be fine. Get a bit of ice and sugar on both sides and roll it out. We're aiming to roll to about 1 centimeter thick. I don't know what that is in inches, but I feel like inches are overrated. We're gonna transfer it into the tin. It's probably not gonna go well, but like, it's gonna be okay. Everything's gonna be fine. This is not the worst thing that's gonna happen this year. Actually, not too bad. So rather than flopping the edges over the side of the pastry, I flop them in because then they don't break. And you basically just want to press it into the corners and push it up the sides. There you go. There you go. Oh, stunning. If it starts to crack or get some holes, just cover them up. Like you do with your mental health, you know. And then using a sharp knife and carefully, we're just going to trim it away from the edges. I probably shouldn't, but I like it raw, so. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Oh my god, Mum's gonna watch this. Right. We use the offcuts and we plug any gaps, and if you need to, you just squeeze it into the edges. And no one will ever know because the cracks will be on the inside, not the outside. Now, especially if you've gone in a bit too soon to start lining your tin, you do need to chill it again, which is annoying, but I promise it's worth it. Ideally for an hour in the fridge. I can never be bothered to wait for that long, so I'm gonna pop it in the freezer for about half an hour. There you go. Into the freezer we go. But we don't, because I'm actually going to get one I made earlier. Here's what we made earlier. I've forgotten to turn the oven on, which is a rookie error. So I'm going to go and do that after I filled this. And by the power of the edit, you won't know. We're going to preheat the oven to about, I need to read this, hang on. If you're in Britain, 10 minutes at 180 degrees fan, and then 30-ish minutes at 170 degrees fan. Then Google says, if you're American, that's 400 degrees Fahrenheit for 10 minutes, and then 375 for about 30 minutes. And if you're using whatever a gas oven is, you're at gas mark 6 for 10 minutes, and then gas mark 5 for about 30. There you go, maths. What you're looking for basically is we're gonna cook it hot for a short while, and that will puff the pastry, and then we're gonna lower the temperature a bit, and that will cook the center. The edges will puff up a wee bit, but it's done. When the edges are puffed, you've got a bit of a wobble in the center, like me. And there we are. Nearly dropped it then, but I didn't, and that's the important thing. So we're gonna let that cool just a wee bit, and then we're gonna make the meringue that we can put on top. Leave the oven on and keep it at the same temperature as it was just on. Whatever I said to you, I can't remember what it is, but that's the one we're sticking with. Gonna pop it over here to cool and try not to drop it. Oh. Okay, so time to make the meringue topping. We're gonna do like basic bitch meringue. We're not gonna do any of that Swiss or Italian meringue nonsense. We're going for basic bitch. So, you need a bowl and then some egg whites. So I've got 114 grams of egg whites. And then we're gonna double that, and it's that amount of sugar. So 112 times 2 is. Hey Siri, what is 112 times 2? Cut to this. 112 times 2 is 224 maths. So I've got my egg whites here. I'm gonna weigh out 224 grams of sugar, and then we'll get cracking. We're just gonna whisk this until it starts going quite frothy and a bit foamy. So that's now a wee bit foamy. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna add a couple of drops of lemon juice. That's just gonna stabilize it just a wee bit. I'm also gonna add a wee bit of vanilla as well. And now we're gonna keep whisking until it goes to soft peaks. So that means it's gonna lift up, then drop over on itself. There's a joke in there about soft peaks, but I'm gonna resist it. So now we're at soft peaks. If you lift it up, it kind of dissolves back onto itself. We're gonna add the sugar quite slowly, so just a couple of spoonfuls at a time. You don't want to deflate all the air that you're whipping in. And whisk well in between. It's getting stiffer. Am I right or am I wrong? Sorry. I'm not sorry, actually. That's very funny and you should be laughing, okay? And there you have it. You have meringue and a good technique to test it's done is to turn it upside down over your head. Oh God. It's fine. Meringue done. So the pumpkin pie is still a bit warm, but we're gonna spread the meringue on top and then we're gonna bake it just a wee bit more to get a nice crunchy top, as it were. I think there's plenty crunchy tops at the moment, aren't there? I'm not even sure what that means. There we are, lovely. So make sure you start around the edges. Because the pumpkin is hot, it's gonna start cooking, and that means it might start trying to kind of spread itself around to the center. So you need to attach it to the edges to sort of anchor it on. Make sure you don't go too over the edges though, because then it's never gonna come out of the tin. And don't say I didn't tell you so. Oh God, I love sugar. Look at this. You can pile it as high as you like. I like to have a fairly even layer. I like to make sure the top and the bottom are both equal in this relationship. But I mean, you can go for a stronger top should you so wish. I've all seen enough of strong tops personally, but that's a conversation for another day, isn't it? We're gonna go back into the oven now. We're gonna leave it in there until the top is kind of caught nice and brown. And then it's time to eat it. Oh God, imagine if I dropped it now. So it's been about 10 minutes and the meringue on top is going a bit brown. You can leave it as much as you want. I want mine to be only lightly brown, but if you go darker brown, it's a bit more chewy. Totally up to you, but mine's done, so I'm gonna go get it out. Stop it. And that is the finished pumpkin pie. Now you can be brave if you want and you can try and take it out of the tin. I don't want to be brave because I'm being filmed, so I'm just gonna eat it like that because I think it looks good enough. So. That is a pumpkin pie. I'm gonna ruin this and just go straight in with a spoon. It's only me that's gonna be eating it anyway, so let's just crack in. Oh, that's a satisfying noise. Oh, look at that. Can I fit all that in my mouth? No, I can't. It's delicious though. Oh, that is really good. Well, this is my pudding and main course. And starter, sorted. Let's see how you got on. Oh my God, that's so good. Happy, thanks. Oh shit, it's all over the floor now. Happy Thanksgiving! Whatever that means.